Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can embed your Tella videos into Framer websites. A couple of different ways. So we've got a website in Framer and we want to put a video here. Now, the first way we are going to embed a video from Tella is to just embed it inline. So the Tella video will just load directly on our web page. So the first thing we need to do for that is to insert an embed component. So if you go to utility and then go to embed and just drag this thing here, and now you can see there's a little placeholder. If you get that selected and then head over to the right, you'll see we've got some embed options, URL and HTML, and then we've got a spot for URL when we have that one on and a spot for a bunch of HTML. I'm going to show you first the URL option. So let's now head into Tella. And here's the video that we're going to be working with. Nice video of yours truly. And I'm just going to copy the link from my address bar, switch back into Framer, paste that into the URL. And instead of just pasting it as it is, I'm just going to delete the last few letters where it says view and then replace that with embed. And now you can see that our video is showing up. And then all I like to do is just to reduce the size of the embed component so that it fits nicely around the video, and then head over here and just lock the aspect ratio. And that means that you can then like go and make this 100% or whatever you want to do. And that'll keep the aspect ratio the way you want it. And then you can go and set like a max width or something. So that it behaves a bit nicer. So that looks pretty good. So if we preview this, hit play, there's our video. Easy. But we can do a little bit better than this because here we have this video loading on our website, but you know, maybe we don't want the record your own button. Maybe we don't want the avatar and the name of the video. So let's pop back into the Framer editor. And now what we're going to do is we're going to use the HTML option. So I'm going to switch to that. And now I'm going to go back to Tella and open up the embed settings. And here you can see there is a bunch of options that you can toggle on and off when you use the embed code. When you just grab the URL, these things don't apply. But when you get the full iframe, you can set all these properties. So if we pop back in here and switch off the title and the avatar, you can see on the preview here that that disappears. We can get rid of the record your own button, and we could decide if we want it to autoplay, but that may not be, actually that's not what I want to happen. And I want to keep the animated thumbnail, but if you want, you can have a static thumbnail. So let's just go and copy the embed code. Again, if you want to preview it, just head in here and you can see all the details. And so now we can go back into Framer, paste this in here, and then there we go. There is our video. And this time we don't have the avatar, the creator's avatar and the name. And when we go and preview this, it's much cleaner, which is pretty cool. But sometimes you want even more control over the video and how it looks and works on your web page. And often it's just not possible to directly embed an iframe into whatever part of the page you want to have a video. So that's where Framer's overlay feature comes in. So here you can see I've got this fun hover state. I animate in the play button and then viewers can click on this. Welcome to the video. And then the video autoplays in an overlay. You can see another example of this here where we have this thumbnail. It's kind of part of this card and viewers can again hover over the thumbnail here and open up the overlay. Let's take a look. Or they could just click on the button. The neat thing with overlays is it lets you separate the playback and the watching experience of the video from the preview, which is really there to catch people's attention. The other thing is it means you can also optimize your website even further because you have control over the preview, which is going to be the thing that loads on your web page. So you can like compress down the video file and make it smaller so that it loads faster than loading a full-on iframe onto your website. So back in Framer, we've got our website and we've got another video, but this time it's not a embed component with a Tella video in it. It's just Framer's own video component. And you can add this from the insert menu, media, and then video. And once you've got that added, then you've got a bunch of properties that you can play around with, which mean that you can create a really nice effect with the preview. So what I've done here is I've uploaded just a few seconds of my original video. And ideally, you would get the most exciting, eye-catching seconds so you can really get people's attention. And then I've compressed this short video file using a tool like Handbrake or FFmpeg, so that it's as optimized as possible to load quickly on the web page. And then I can set it to autoplay, loop it, mute it, hide the controls and all that stuff. And then the result is this. So you get this really nice video autoplaying, super clean, and you could have more fun with the hover state. You could add the play button like we saw in the earlier examples. So now we've got our preview. We want to actually add the overlay where people can watch the full video. So I've actually wrapped the Framer video component in a another component here. If I head over to the right here, I'm gonna go and add an overlay. So if we add that, I'm gonna pick a fixed one, which is what you want for this type of thing. But you can see now that I've added the overlay, it's behind the menu and behind the video. I'm gonna just change this to 9. That should be enough. Cool. And so now we've got the black overlay over the top. You can play around with a bunch of the properties here, but the next thing we're gonna do to get our video on there is we're gonna go back to the insert menu and we're just gonna repeat what we did in the first example where we just embedded the iframe. And so I'm gonna go to the utilities option and then the embed, chuck that in here. And now I'm gonna switch back to Tella. And we're going to grab that code again. And in fact, I'm going to disable this, and I'm going to autoplay because once they have clicked on the preview, they're kind of saying, yeah, I want to watch the video. So now let's copy the embed code, Framer, paste that in. So now that we've pasted this in, we just need to fix up the size here. So again, what I like to do is just to kind of get this kind of outer component fitting around the Tella video and then make that fixed. And then you can play around with its position or whatever. And then you can hit done. Let's go and check this out. There's our preview. We can hover, we can open it up, and it autoplays.